Dig this. 4 arrested, 42 citations issued during Broadway weekend mask enforcement. Let me say that again. 4 people got arrested for wearing a mask, for not wearing a mask. Wow. Nashville, y'all. Yep. It's good. You're getting nuts, okay? Metro Police issued 42 citations and arrested 4 people for violating the Nashville mask mandate during the department's first weekend of enhanced enforcement on Broadway. Now, 20 of those citations, they were written Friday. Mm-hmm. Okay, 18 were issued Saturday. And they added 1 arrest by...
That's pretty good.
1 arrest was Friday. The 3 were Saturday.
Uh-huh.
Arrests. Now, the police had announced that they would increase their presence on Broadway over the weekend to ensure the compliance. You know, they put this 10 o'clock curfew. Don't forget that, too.
Oh, yeah.
Down there. Okay, well, you get a ticket if you're walking around at 10 o'clock down there. Okay, did you know that part? Oh, well, they don't want to tell you that part.
Oh, you get a ticket for walking around?
Yeah, there's a curfew.
It's a curfew.
Curfew.
You have to get something essential.
I thought I was old enough to, you know, to do what I can. Long as I'm not hurting nobody.
Nope.
You know what I'm saying? Dang.
You know what? I feel bad for these officers, but if I was one of these officers, I would not be riding these friggin' I wouldn't arrest someone.
Nope.
How much is the ticket?
$50.
Yeah, violation of the mask is considered a Class C misdemeanor under state law, punishable by a fine up to 50, or as many as 30 days in jail, by the way.
So,
oh my gosh.
So I'm going to do the habitual offender law take place if you get caught without a mask more than once.
This is crazy. This is crazy. Let me see the numbers here. Yeah, unbelievable. So, speaking of which, I want to go over this one. Someone sent me this on Twitter. I didn't believe it until I read the article and I reached out to the councilwoman out of Nashville. Nashville City Councilwoman recommends attempted murder charges for someone not wearing face mist.
Okay.
You heard it. You just heard it.
Attempted murder.
Oh, man. Really?
I reached out to her. I said, "Come, you got to come on the show." I said, this story must be taking your words out of context.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, the Nashville, Tennessee councilwoman, okay, wants those who don't wear this face mask during the coronavirus pandemic to be charged. Well, she wants you to be charged with attempted murder.
No.
Sharon Hurt.
No.
Okay?
No.
Sharon Hurt, councilwoman of Nashville Metro Council.
No. Well, it's like what I said, man. No. No.
Hey, there was this meeting August 5th,
mm-hmm.
Okay, a couple days ago. 5 days ago now. Between public safety, beer and regulated beverages, and health hospitals and social services.
But then again, like they trying.
She said during the meeting, quote, "My question goes back to legislation, but my concern is, you know, I work for an organization that if they pass a virus, then they are tried for murder or attempted murder if they are not told."
No.
"And this person, quote, who may be very well pass this virus that's out in the air because they're not wearing a mask is basically doing the same thing to someone who contracts it and dies from it."
What about somebody that having sex and not wearing a condom that's spreading diseases?
Put them in jail.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying.
No, I know, Bay. That's the thing. If someone willingly knows that they have HIV,
it's the same thing with if you sick.
But you have, right.
Mm-hmm.
You have to know it.
But that's the same way.
If you don't know it, then how do you?
It's the same way. A lot of people.
It's crazy.
A lot of people don't know if they got COVID or not.
Yep. Mm-hmm. It's crazy. Unreal.
Yeah.
And you always hear people here recently talk about, they were saying, "Oh, back in November, I believe I had it."
Mm-hmm.
They're like, "Oh, I was sick, couldn't figure it out. Doctors didn't know what it was."
Listen, in the U.S., all right, I'm a numbers guy, I'm a facts guy. 65,756,307 COVID-19 tests conducted in the U.S., okay? Over 65. 65.7 million tests conducted. So, today we hit 5 million positive tests. That's how many we hit. So, that's less than 10% positive cases from these tests. That's not bad. And death rates are down. And don't get me wrong. I get it. It's tough, especially on the older crowd. I get it. If you're afraid, don't go out. If you're afraid, put on a mask. Whatever. Do what you got to do. If you're not afraid, if you're in a category that has 0.00001 death rate, like my age group, I'm not scared. Now, if I go see one of my older friends, maybe have a cigar or something at their place, I'll go wear a mask. Stupid, because I take off the mask when I have the cigar with the guy. Do you know what I mean? I want to go out to dinner with grandma. Yeah, sure. You know what? I'll wear a mask. We're going to sit down at the table and I'm going to take off my mask sitting down next to grandma. You know what I mean?
In the beginning, nobody knew what was going on. Mm-hmm. It was scientifically driven. Nobody knew what was going on.
Yeah.
Now it feels more political.
It's no longer
about the science.
You nailed it.
Yeah.
It's about politics.
Oh yeah. I told you they were gonna do it.
We of course in the beginning, even I was a little like this seems pretty serious, but right. You know, let's take precautions. You know. And now we've done all the precautions, we've done all the stuff, and they still don't want to give it up. Now you start going. Mm-hmm. Now it seems like Democrats, Republicans, that you know, they're all here trying to do something. It's just like
chaos.
We're in the middle of it.
Chaos. Yeah, you know, have people unsure, have people fear. Don't fear, my friends. Mm-mm. Be smart. Yeah. Don't fear. When you have fear, I don't know. It mitigates your ability to think straight. So keep a cool head on your shoulders. Look out for others. Look out for yourself. I'm not wearing a mask. If you want to shame me into wearing one, guilt me into wearing one, what are you going to do when they say that, okay, you have to go outside, you ever want to go into public, you have to wear a mask? Okay. What are you going to do one day when you go outside and you go into public and they say, hey, we found the vaccine, you have to put this in your body? How many people are not going to just wear it already? Just shoot yourself with it already. Okay? Think about it. I'm playing chess here for you. Not for me, for you. I'm doing this for you, my friends. I already did my fight, you know what I mean? It was an honor to serve, by the way. And it was. All right, let's, one more story, good news. You know all the party buses, right? Down in Nashville, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, woo, party buses, yeah! Well, I mean, with all the curfew and the shutdown, all gone, right? You know where they went? Franklin! They went to Franklin. The party buses have been shut down under Mayor John Cooper and the Nashville Public Health orders. They found a new home this weekend. They went to Franklin to go, right. Screw you, I'm going home to Franklin.
Yeah.
These party buses have, it's what do they call it? A transportatement or whatever? Mm-hmm. The combined transport and entertainment. I hate it when they do it. But
Las Vegas.
Right.
I lived and worked in Las Vegas.
Oh my God.
So they had party buses all the time.
Oh, your show. It's so infotainment. No. Don't me a favor. Don't.
don't.
Okay. Thank you. Appreciate it. Thank you for the compliment. Move on. Yeah, so the Honky Tonk Party Express, okay? And they're like, screw it. We'll go to Franklin. Downtown Franklin, you want us? You got us. Come to Clarksville, y'all. Look at these pictures. Nobody's wearing masks and nothing. Nobody cares. Nobody cares anymore. They're done. Sorry, I don't mean to get upset. You know why they're done? Because you let Walmart stay open while you close mom and pop shop. Okay? While you close Caprigio's, you let them go buy pizza at Walmart in the frozen food section, right?
Sam's Club.
Hell, if Lowe's put up a friggin'... Right. If come on. Stop screwing us around. Stop screwing us around. Get off my back and get on my side where you belong.
I like
I want to curse.
Yeah, you can feel it. You want to get aggressive.
But I won't. I'm going to control my emotions. It's a sign of intelligence.
Bastards.
It's better than the F word, I was going to say. Ah, all right.
Forget about it.
Forget about it.
Yeah.
Speaking of which, don't forget about that Caprigio's pizza. Congratulations to Cindy for winning that pizza for a month. From Caprigio's Pizza. Yeah, Caprigio's Pizza, Clarksville.com. What'd you learn on the show today? Any one thing stand out for you today, Colas?
I didn't know there was a book.
Oh, yes, there's a book.
I didn't realize there was that. I didn't know there was a book called that.
I can't wait to read it.
You're going to love it. You're going to learn a lot of things.
Vice versa with the book I give you.
Okay.
I promise
you.
It's
on. We'll do book reports for each other.
Good. Book club.
Yes.
I love it. All right. Let's see. All right, Chantel, what'd you learn on the show today?
This pizza's amazing. I just had like 4 slices.
Right? It hits the spot. It's good stuff.
It's really good.
Right.
It's our new pizza spot. So we moved here a week ago. So
good job.
We're excited.
Good job today. Destiny, what'd you learn on the show today?
That children are apparently 20 years old.
Oh, my God. Right? Like, you know what? They do these tests. They pair these numbers. The children. Wait a minute. 24 years old? Children.
It's called fluffing the numbers a little bit.
24 years old. Some of them's losing hair at this point. Yeah. Like Alyssa Milano.
Definitely fluffing the numbers.
You're doing great things already here.
Trying.
Proud that you're here. And yes, you will win the Maxim CoverGirl competition.
I need your help.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We need your help. Help put us on the map.
I'm trying.
Damn right. Love it. Glad you're here. The links are on the live video feed. Bae, what'd you learn on the show today?
Caprigio's.
Got Caprigio's Pizza. Fantastic, yeah. Right?
Caprigio's Pizza. And then Chef, you know, Ilona's Table.
Right.
Italian cuisine.
Uh-huh.
214 Media.
I love it.
I'm getting them all in.
Good times.
Take advantage of
it. I love it.
That was my agenda just as much as, you know.
It's perfect.
We help each other.
Yeah, damn right. That's what it's all about.
Help each other.
Right.
And I appreciate you. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Of course. We'll do this more often.
I appreciate it.
I say once a month. We'll call it the pizza period. Get it? Once a month. It's an extra sauce. All right. Stop.
All right, I'm ready.
Stop.
All right. Wait, it pales very well with the book. With the book.
You started it by bringing in that freaking book. All right, you started.
I'm sorry.
Here's what I learned on the show today. Don't just read the headline. Read the entire story. Okay, if you want to get information, go get information. Don't wait for it to be just handed to you. Because guess what? People that are handing out information for free, they're handing out for free for something, all right? Yeah. It's like crack. If you're going to buy it, buy the good stuff. No, don't buy crack. Don't buy crack. All right, hey, we'll see you. We'll see you tomorrow. We got more guests, more you. Who's coming on the tomorrow, bae?
I don't know.
Me neither. Hold on. I do know. Tomorrow's Tuesday, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Tuesday is... We got trivia tomorrow night, too, at Tennessee Valley Brewing Company.
Oh, that's awesome.
Yeah, R-rated trivia. So don't bring the kids. Come Tuesday night.
We're also doing Takeout Tuesdays on Caprigio's Pizza. That's another thing that...
Takeout Tuesdays?
Yeah, we're hooked up with Casey.
That's right.
Takeout Tuesdays, and that's something...
Oh, you guys hooked up with Casey? Oh, I hope you have some Banaka.
Listen... And on that too, that's a good movie reference. Also, Wednesday, we're Lona's Table. We're doing our official grand opening.
Okay, good
Lona's
deal.
Table.
That's tomorrow.
No, Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Wednesday. Official grand opening.
Is this Wednesday?
We're going to have Mayor Pitts there.
Good
Chamber
deal.
Commerce,
yes.
Ribbon cutting.
That's what's up.
1 o'clock is the official time.
Good
Wednesday
for you.
For Lona's Table.
I love it.
Yeah, right there.
I love it. Good times. All right, my friends, we'll see you tomorrow here on the Joe Padula Show, where Clarksville goes to Party with a Purpose.
Go vote, Maxim.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Woo.